Hi, I'm Lori Handy, talking to you today from the Vaccine Education Center at Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. Today, we'll be talking about the conjugated pneumococcal vaccines for children. First, let's talk about the disease we're trying to prevent. So pneumococcus, or Streptococcus pneumoniae, is a bacteria that causes infections in infants, young toddlers, and even the elderly. Prior to the introduction of vaccine, we had upwards of 700 cases of meningitis, 17,000 bloodstream infections, and up to 5 million ear infections, all due to pneumococcus. So, of course, this made it a prime target for vaccine development. How does this bacteria actually cause disease? So it lives in the back of our throats, a little bit in our noses, and when we have breakdown of the lining of those areas, perhaps from a viral infection or direct trauma, the bacteria can then invade and cause invasive disease, such as meningitis, pneumonia, or other invasive infections. Before we talk more about vaccine development, I'm going to digress for just a minute. There are two other bacteria that can cause this scope of disease. They're called Haemophilus influenzae and Neisseria meningitidis, both of which have vaccines. Back in the 1980s, when scientists were developing vaccines for Haemophilus influenzae, there was just one type that they were worried about, type B, making a single vaccine that we talk about called HIB, Haemophilus influenzae type B. Similarly, when we talk about Neisseria meningitidis, there's five types that we're concerned about. And between two vaccines, we're now able to protect individuals from this bacteria as well. All right, so now let's go back to pneumococcus. There are about 90 different types of pneumococcal strains that can cause infections. Over time, we've developed first a vaccine for 7, then 13, then 15, and now up to 20 types. What this means is that we've dramatically decreased the rates of disease by using these pneumococcal conjugate vaccines. What does it mean actually to be a conjugate vaccine? This is that as the vaccine is developed, a harmless protein is also included, which helps your baby or young child's immune system better recognize that there is a vaccine present and something to make an immune response to. This makes them better protected and makes the vaccine more effective for young children. So, with each vaccine that's been developed over time, we're really able to better understand if there's any remaining strains that can cause invasive disease and continue to add those to the current repertoire of vaccines. I hope after today you have a better understanding of how and why these vaccines are developed and how they've changed over time. Thank you for taking the time to listen.